Morning students. Today we are going to start poetry section from Flamingo, and our first poem is My Mother at 66, written by Kamala Das.
Today we are going to start My Mother at 66, written by Kamala Das. Let us first know about Kamala Das. Her Malayalam pen name is Madhavi Kutti. She was born on 31st March 1934 in Thrissur, Malabar Coast, which is now in Kerala. Kamala Das was part of a generation of Indian writers whose work centered on personal rather than colonial experiences, and her short stories, poetry, memoir and essays brought her respect and notoriety in equal measures. Das wrote both in English, mostly her poetry, and under the pen name Madhavi Kutti in the Malayalam language of southern India. Now, before starting the poem, let us discuss about the form of this poem. It's written in free verse. Now, what is free verse? Free verse is a poetry that does not has any rhyme or have a regular rhythm. Now, it is a confessional poem. Now, confessional poem is described as poetry of the personal or I, focusing on extreme moments of individual experience, the psyche, and personal trauma. Let us discuss about the theme of this poem. We have three different themes which are dealt in this poem. The first one is aging, second one is separation, and third one is filial love. Aging, as the title itself says, My Mother at 66. Now, this is about the aging process, separation due to death or decay, and filial love is basically the love of kids or children towards their mother. Central idea of the poem. Now, My Mother at 66 is a poignant or touchy poem by Kamala Das, which deals with the themes of aging, a person's love for her mother, separation, uncertainty, and death. A sensory and deeply sensitive poem, My Mother at 66 is the first person confessional poem that captures the reader's attention and provides a glimpse of the subtle intricacies of a mother-daughter relationship. The poem captures the speaker's train of thought, and the entire poem is written in a single sentence. It is a unique feature of this poem that entire poem is written in a single sentence. Now, let us start the poem. Driving from my parents' home to Cochin last Friday morning, I saw my mother beside me. Explanation of these lines, that the idea of movement is central to understand this poem. The physical movement, first movement is physical movement to the airport. Both of them, they are moving towards airport. The emotional journey of the poet, we'll see that what sort of emotions are coming. Initially, she was thinking about her mother's death, then she tried to get rid of that thought and she looked outside, and again while she was parting, she was thinking about her mother's death and she was trying to hide those emotions behind smile. So this is emotional journey, and movement of her mother towards old age. These are intermingled in this poem, which is about love, longing and separation. Now notice the first word of the poem. It's a verb for movement in the present continuous tense. Driving from my parents' home. Driving. It's a verb for movement and it is in present continuous tense. The poet was driving from her parents' house to Cochin Airport the previous Friday. While inside the car, she happens to see her mother beside her doze off. Doze open-mouthed, her face ashen like that of a corpse, and realized with pain that she was as old as she looked, but soon put that thought away and looked out at young trees sprinting and merry children spilling out of their homes. Now, explanation of these lines, the striking image of a woman weakened by age, dozing off with her mouth open, leaves a very strong impression on the speaker, who feels that her mother's face resembles the pale face of a dead body, like that of a corpse. Now you can imagine that how painful this thought is for the poet. The thought of her mother rapidly advancing, quite like them in the car, towards death, deeply disturbs her and she attempts to put the thought away by looking outside the window, where she sees trees running and children playing. This transition, now see the difference between what is there inside the car and what is there outside the car. This transition from the stillness of the dozing mother to the frivolity and movement of youth through a single glance is simply remarkable. The literary device of contrast is used to bring out the distinctive features of two different worlds separated by a window pane. See, this is a contrast. This is a literary device which is used here. We can see that there are two different worlds. One world is there inside the car and other world is there outside the car. And these two different worlds, they are separated by a window pane. And what these two worlds are? One with the infirmity of old age and the other tinted with frolic of youth. The device of personification used to describe the trees sprinting outside. Now in this particular phrase sprinting, this device personification is used. Sprinting is basically when you run very fast. Now trees, they are static, but here sprinting word is used, and personification is a device in which an inanimate object is treated as animate object. They are likened to children, young trees sprinting while describing their apparent movement as seen from inside the car. Now it is a physical phenomena that when we are there in sitting inside a moving vehicle, whatever is there outside which is static, it seems as if it is running in the opposite direction. The same case is there with the young trees which are there on the both sides of the road. The merry children, on the other hand, are said to be spilling out of their homes. Now this word spilling is basically used for fluids, but here it is used for the happy movement of children. But after the airport's security check, standing a few yards away, I looked again at her wan, pale as a late winter's moon and felt that old familiar ache, my childhood's fear. Explanation of these lines. When the speaker looks at her mother standing a few yards away from the airport security check, the mother's face is described by a simile. Now see, it is a normal process that when we reach there to airport, there is security check. They reach now, both of them, they reach there to Cochin airport, and after security check, both of them, they are standing few yards away from each other. Now she again looked at her mother. And she's describing her mother's face with the these words, warm, pale as late winter's moon. Here, a literary device simile is used. A brilliant imagery of winter moon is used in this part of the poem. Winter is used to evoke a sense of an ending, a certain frigid, inert state, and the inevitable darkness that it follows. Also, moon has stereotypically received a feminine treatment, and simile as a pale moon is quite apt to describe the round pale face of aged mother. On seeing her mother, the poet experiences that familiar old ache, my childhood fear. Now see, it is not described that what sort of pain, what sort of familiar ache she is talking about that she has experienced there during her childhood. It is not given here, but we can infer that she is talking about the fear of losing her mother. Might be during her childhood also she has experienced the same pain, and now she is experiencing the same old familiar ache. But all I said was, "See you soon, Amma." All I did was smile and smile and smile. Though she was quite thoughtful about her mother's present, her old age, and what will happen to her future, the speaker can neither stop herself from going away. Obviously, she has to go back and she cannot stop herself there. Neither she can, stop her mother from going away from her forever. So this is a state of dilemma in which she was standing there and she looked at her mother. There were mixed feelings inside her. All she can do is part with the hope. She was nothing was there except a hope that might be she'll again come back and meet her mother. The parting is made all the more poignant by the fact that she hopes to see her mother. She fears that she might not. And she's trying to hide this feeling by saying or by giving an assurance, a sort of assurance to herself as well as to her mother in these words, "See you soon, Amma." And the intermingling of emotions of love, hope, longing, nostalgia, fear, and a sense of helplessness at the face of the inevitable seems to find its way in the repetition of the final words of the poem. "All I did was smile and smile and smile." Now, this word smile is used three times, and this is just to, you know, emphasize that it was a forced smile. She was trying to hide her pain behind this smile. Now, we have completed the poem. Let us discuss about the tone of the poem. The tone of the poem is predominantly pensive. Pensive, something that is full of sorrow or pain. The poet suddenly notices that her mother looks as old as she is. This could have surprised her, since she only sees her mother during holidays and not on a daily basis. However, it does not surprise her because she has always been aware of the certainty of her mother's death. As she does when she turns away from her mother to look at the trees and the children. She has simply chosen not to think about losing her mother anytime soon. Yet that fear has always plagued her, and it plagues her still. This saddens her, and one can see her silent tears even when she has forced herself to smile. Now, let us discuss poetic devices which are used there in the poem. The first one is simile. This rhetorical device is used when an overt comparison is made between two different things. In this poem, the poet uses this device of simile on two instances. In line 5-7, she compares her mother's face with that of a corpse and also uses the word like while making that comparison. In lines 15-16, she again compares her mother with moon in winter time and also uses the word as while making this comparison. Simile is something very common in use in poems. Now, a personification. This rhetorical device is used to bestow human qualities to someone that is not human. In this poem, the poet uses the device of personification in line 12 with respect to the trees. She imagines the trees to be figures that are running alongside her car. Apostrophe. This rhetorical device is used when a poet addresses his or her poem to an absent audience. In this poem, the poet uses the device of apostrophe in line 18 when she speaks directly to her mother, addressing her as Amma, even though we never see her mother replying to the poet. Then contrast is used. The literary device of contrast is used to bring out the distinctive features of the two different worlds separated by a window pane. One with the infirmity of old age and the other tinted with the frolic of youth. Repetition. Repetition is a literary device that repeats the same words or phrases a few times to make an idea more clearer and more memorable. A smile in the last line is an example.